where we have Mr. Diaz, who is the coach of, I understand, the prison football team. Never knew the prison had a football team, but we're going to get some more information here. Mr. Diaz, good afternoon and welcome to Ask 25.
Good afternoon.
Tell us a bit about what is happening here with this team.
Well, you said that you didn't know we had a football team. Well, actually, we've had a football team for quite a number of years. We are just trying to revamp the football team and make us a little more noted outside in public. Mm-hmm. But we have been playing in East Zone for many, many years. It's just about really bringing us together, bringing the service together through sport.
And all the players are prison officers?
No, we extend to the community as well, and we have players who are not prison officers at this time. Yeah.
Okay. Are we going to be seeing members of the youth training center on this team?
Well, we have a YTC team, and we hope really to use the YTC as a feeder. Okay. We hope to get some good young players coming out of the YTC, okay. Yes.
Now, what's the plan really for this team? Because it's a revamp here now. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you all don't want to come out on the scene for the next 2-3 months or a year or so, and then you go on back again. So you must have some serious plans here now.
Yes. We have made a lot of changes in the way we do things, because we intend really to win the East Zone, win out and move on to the Super League, and sometime in the future move on to the professional football as well. In order to do that, we have changed our structure. We have a proper coaching staff now. We also have very good players as well, and we have brought the team up to about 30 something or so players, with the hope really to win the league, and with the intention to win the league and to go forward again from there.
So you all are currently in competition in the East Zone. How is the team performing so far?
Well, we started well. We had some good practice game coming forward. We were fortunate enough to play some of the pro teams, and we did well. We won one of the games, and we did okay in the others. Not bad at all, and it's showing now. In the competition has just started. We drew our first game. We played WASA at home, a 1-1 draw, and we won our second game in Mova against Boss. We won 3-1.
What are some of the little difficulties you all are facing presently? Because I mean, you have good plans. Your ambition is nice, Super League, Pro League. But what are some of the things that is in ahead of you all that you all need to get organized properly?
Well, as always, when you have a service team, you always have that issue with time to train and time for games, because remember, the job comes first at all times. So that's one of the challenges that we have, and we have always had, and you know, we work around it as best we could. We get a lot of support from the administration, we get support from the officers in charge, the supervisors, etc. So we try our best to get around that. The other challenge, really, we're trying to the use of the ground is a challenge as well, because you know, we share the ground with the YTC lads, with all the different things that they have going on. So that's some of the little challenges. But generally, we don't have that much challenges as some of the other teams, the community teams have. So we should do well based on that. Yeah.
Tell me a bit about the players. Who are some of the players that long term you can expect to see them, you know, rising and standing against some of the best?
Yes. But we have a good mixture of youth and experience. We try to have a good blend. We have that now. We have a good captain at present, Mr. Reyes. He's doing well as a captain. We have a young goalkeeper who is not a prison officer, Jevon is doing well as well. He's a young guy. I think he's for the future. We have some young guys. We have a young Diaz on the team, no relation, but he's doing well at present. We have a good forward. We have Ricardo Allen as well, who is not an officer, doing very well. He has all the goals for us at the moment. I have a good staff as well, as I said. And just a few young players. I have young Pierre, who is a stopper, who is a centre back, who's doing very well. But what we really want to be a team, as in team effort, and not just let it be about one or two players. Yes, yeah. And that's working out fine.
Well, Mr. Diaz, let me take this opportunity to wish you and the team all the best. And I know I'm going to be following up on you all, maybe coming to one of the games to see the performance of the team. But we want to wish you all the best. And Super League, Pro League, I mean, there's no stopping you all once you all put the plans in place.
Yeah, I have given that commitment to the administration as well. It really started with a three-year plan, and this is the third year, and I'm expecting to be successful this year. Yeah. For us to
so, end of this year, next year will be Super League?
Yes.
Okay, we'll be looking forward, and remember, this is a national television, so you have to make sure that
yes.
Super League, we see you in the Super League. So again, thank you very much, and all the best to you and the team.
Thank you very much as well. Yep. Thanks for coming.
Yeah. Well, there you heard it from the coach of the prison football team, Mr. Diaz, telling us a bit about this team here presently. They're in the Northern League, looking to win that league, going to Super League, going to Pro League. Well, there's also the police and the army, so why not a prison team in the Pro League? So we want to wish them all the best. Remember, this is Axe 25, and we are at the YTC in Arouca. So stay tuned.